Madam Mandira ma'am, you have adopted the yes mom challenge yourself. So would you like to share a situation or an instant when, you know, this yes word actually helped? Like you said, B does play a song for you every day in the morning, yes, saying does. That you've become his best friend.
But there's this other thing, 2 weeks ago I flagged off a family marathon. And it was families running together, parents, children. And Veera and I were just supposed to flag it off. And I said, look, I don't know. He doesn't run. We haven't run together. So if you want us to run, maybe for some photographs, we will. But we flagged the marathon off. And I'm always concerned, don't run fast. You'll get hurt. You'll scrape your knees. Don't. That day I decided, I said, he and I are going to run. And we'll run as much as we can run. And you know, like I said, we hold our children back. We shouldn't hold them back, because that day I discovered, without holding him back, without saying no to him, with saying a lot of yeses to him and encouraging him along the way, only thing I told him was, run at the speed that I'm running. Don't try and speed, because you'll get tired. He ran 2 kilometers. And he ran 2 kilometers without stopping, without saying, Mama, I'm getting tired. I found a new running partner. I never thought that would be a possibility, that my son and I are going to go for a run, and we're going to do that now on Sunday mornings, because this just happened. So here was a case of me saying yes, me not holding him back. And sometimes, you know, your children surprise you, because this was a huge surprise for me. You know, all children run around. They'll run around wherever they see space. But here I got a chance to discover something new about him. And that's because I didn't say no.
How beautiful was that? Well, ladies, coming on to the last question, any messages that you would want to say to the yes moms that we have? Yes moms, make some noise for yourself.
Woohoo! Before saying anything, as a message, I'd like to say this product that, okay, you know, Active Kids Immuno Boosters, is like a, for mothers, it's like a prayer answered. It really is, because, you know, you're so concerned about your child getting the recommended dietary allowance and you're not always getting it. Like for me, my son doesn't even eat junk food. He generally eats healthy, but he had a deficiency in zinc because he doesn't like to, I suppose, eat fruits. Maybe that's where it's coming from. I'm going to ask you offline.
A lot of moms would have realized certain times you would see a lot of behavioral changes in children. And at times, we always think that this behavior change is due to some particular thing. But it's like a vicious circle. Sometimes, it's just because the child is not getting enough nutrition. And not only nutrition, in terms of even the child is hungry. You know, they show tantrums, they become very cranky. And even the child doesn't know what the problem is. And sometimes the mothers also don't realize. Because sometimes we are making them overeat. And sometimes the child is saying, you know, because we can't go beyond a limit and saying that, okay, the child doesn't want to eat, okay, leave it. And there sometimes it happens. So that behavior change can also be because of the child is not getting enough nutrition and the kind of food they are having. And it's been a lot of times proven that when we see a lot of bees, because my work says that, you know, being counseling, so a lot of mothers would come or the teachers would come in and say, this child is having this problem. And when we go to the roots, we do come to know sometimes because of certain problems, you know, they are not getting food from home, or maybe they are showing so many tantrums, even if the mother is packing the food, they are not ready to take it. And by the time they are in the school, they are not ready to even come to school because they don't even know what is happening to them. So this can be also due to deficiency of certain things, like she talked about the zinc, it can be anything. So that's where we have to look for supplements or the kind of food we are giving to the children, that they are getting the best and proper intake of that balanced diet which should be there.
Wow. Dr. Deepa, would you wish to say something to our lovely moms out there?
I would just like to add on one more thing. I would like to give you an example of, I had these two sisters who come to me with their kids, almost similar age, they're around 4 years approximately. One of them has a nice, healthy child. The other one has a very thin child. I want to let you know by this example that don't go by looks. Looks are often deceptive. Physical, just the weight and the height wouldn't tell you about health. That's not the only indicator of health. So this mother who had a heavy child was almost, I would say, Very, very confident that she has a very healthy child and she's been doing a good job. The other one always kept complaining that, what's wrong? Where am I going wrong? Now, the only difference which the other mom didn't realize is that child who was on the heavier side, who was actually obese, if you put him on the growth chart, he was obese, was the one who regularly used to fall sick. He was the one who was hospitalized twice in the case of these 4 years. Whereas the other one was a happy child, hardly falling sick, a few fevers here and there, like you mentioned, but was a thin child. So don't go by looks. That child was grossly iron deficient. That child was predominantly milk fed. Milk giving him a lot of calories, and unfortunately, a four-year-old child was bottle fed. So this child was heavy with a lot of nutritional deficiencies, majorly iron deficiency, and that was the reason his immunity was at its lowest and he used to fall sick again and again. So this is just to enlighten you not to go just by looks, and the physical growth is not everything. You have to look for this small deficiencies which are not very obvious to us, but can be pinpointed by the fact that the child is falling sick. So lastly, just to end it, what do you mean by a healthy child? Always prevention is better. Always remember, prevention is the key. So for the immunity, a good breastfeed to begin with, breastfeeding, a healthy diet, good nutrition, and if required, as and when there is a fussy or picky eater, nutritional supplements, good sleep, good rest, good exercise, and not to forget a very positive mental attitude in and around our home and environment all around where the child goes. This will bring about a healthy child. Thank you.
So Dr. Neeti, over to you.
The most common question asked by moms is, you know, what is the balanced diet? So like that's the elusive balanced diet. In very, very simple terms, a balanced diet is having a variety of foods in moderation. So there is no food which is a bad food, okay? There can be bad diets where you eat a single food in large quantities or you keep yourself restricted to certain foods and completely eliminate other food groups. But if you eat a variety of foods in moderate quantities, you achieve the elusive balanced diet. And as I said, till the child grows up and understands himself, herself, that, you know, how do I go about it, please take help of products that are available. And as moms, one needs to be less fixated, more imaginative in terms of presentation of food, and also maybe about a food knowledge. Like a lot of people give beet because it's rich in iron. Okay, now that is, a lot of people give bananas because they are rich in calcium. These are some of the biggest myths going around. There is no calcium in banana. So if, yeah, so, yes, that's right. So one just needs to do a bit of reading up and be more well-versed. So then there will be many less no's on the table. Thank you.
So with this, I'm very sure all the lovely moms have a lot of questions, but because of the interest in time, we'll be able to take only two. Yeah? So we're going to take quick two questions for our lovely panelist and Mandira. So any questions coming down from the... Okay. So can we please... volunteers, can we please pass the mic?
Yeah. Hello everyone, and thank you so much for such an amazing session. This is Kushbu here from Mumbai Moms, Momo community. And so my question for y'all is regarding milk. Like, I have a 3.5-year-old daughter. She's not a fussy eater. She'll eat everything I give. Fruits, yes, she loves them. But when it comes to milk, one glass is all she has during the milk. So does that suffice? Is it like okay if she has one? And yes, with something added to it. which I'm not so keen to give her, but because she likes it, it's okay. Yes, mom? So I give it to her.
Right, so as I said, milk is one of the biggest kind of points. So there are daily requirements set by each country for different age groups, okay? Milk being one of the richest sources of calcium. So calcium from milk is the biggest concern. If you're a non-vegetarian, you could get protein from other foods also. Even if you're a vegetarian, you could, if you make sure your child is having enough dals or pulses, you can still complement that. Calcium, so a glass of milk, 200 ml for, you said, three-year-old?
Three and a half-year-old.
Maybe he or she needs a little more than that. And as I said, it doesn't have to be milk. It could be paneer paratha.
Right.
It could be paneer bhurji.
Yogurt.
It could be a fruit smoothie. It could be chaach.
Okay.
It could be lassi.
Yeah, she loves that.
So that glass of milk is not absolutely essential. It could be any form.
I'm going to add to that. You know, it used to be morning, evening milk for my son. And in the evening, there used to be this, on the way back from school, you know, I don't want my milk, and there'd be all this complaint. So I cut down to one glass of milk in the morning. That's non-negotiable, and he has it, and there's no yeses at that time. I'm just saying drink. But in the evening, because he doesn't want to have that glass of milk, I give him, you get these flavored yogurts. They have a little sugar in them, but there's calcium going in, and he enjoys it. And sometimes he doesn't have one, he'll have two. So you just find the alternative, right. I suppose, and there's no fight. There's no drama. It's very cool. He happily has those yogurts, you know.
Glad.
So that helps. So
great. I'm glad. Okay, great. Thank you so much.
We have the next question.
Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for this evening. Basically, I also have a same concern further to what you said. Every time we always think, you know, this is enough quantity of a chocolate. You've eaten an entire brick of a chocolate, now nothing else. So though he eats, for example, my son, he eats a lot of fruits, the other stuff, the other healthy stuff. And thankfully, even the teachers keep telling him this is junk food. So nowadays, he is avoiding it. The only thing is when he mix up with friends, then you end up eating that. He also meets his friends and he sees them eating chips.